What up, guys? TheSighBored here. As usual, it's a cold, dark, wet, rainy day. Or rainy night. Whatever, man. So, it looks like it's the perfect time to be doing some motovlogging. I'm not sure if I'm gonna get soaking wet by the end of it. If I do, I'm probably gonna start getting all cold and shivering and shit like that. So, I don't care. Well, mainly because I'm not working tomorrow. So I don't give a shit if I'm all soaking wet by the time I reach home. Right, straight to the topic then. What shall we be talking about? Motovlog time. I'll just keep it simple. This time, I don't really have anything planned up to be bullshitting about. So maybe I'll just talk about helmets. That bucket for your brain, you know, safety bucket. Talking about motorcycle helmets. Okay, before we start off anything, I'm just gonna say it out loud and say it up front. Always wear a helmet. Only an idiot will not wear a helmet if you're riding a bike. And when I mean riding a bike, I mean like, you know, really riding a bike, not just a small round the block test ride, or you know, cruising around your taman. I mean, you're gonna be riding at fairly cruising speeds, highway speeds, city speeds, whatever. Only a fool will not wear a helmet, so make sure you ain't a fool and you got your goddamn helmet on. So motorcycle helmets, there are many types of motorcycle helmets out in the markets right now, from the basic open face, jet style open face, to the race replicas, all the top of the line race helmets. Other than that, you have your touring helmets, your flip-ups, modular, as well as you have your motocross, MX, dual sport, enduro helmets. So there's so many types of helmets out in the market. Which one is the best? Well, I can't really tell. It's actually really depends on the type of riding you're doing, the type of roads that you're riding on. If you're gonna be out on the off-roading, then definitely the MX motocross helmets will fare better. Especially with the mudguard. If you are doing a lot of racing, a lot of fast riding, I guess the race replica helmets will be, or a full face I guess, will be the best. Modular helmets are a bit heavy, but they offer the flexibility of having the open face by flipping the chin up, as well as a full face, but not really a full-fledged full face type of safety. Open face jet style helmets, those are, the name says it all, right? Open face. Nothing protecting your face, well, maybe a visor. But for myself, okay, I'll get right to it. I would say that I'm not a fan of open face helmets. Yes, I do have open face helmets, and that was back when I was riding scooters. And that was only because there wasn't that many full faces out and about available in the market, and they were pretty damn expensive at the time. As the products get more models and stuff comes along, I'm always gonna be sporting a full face or maybe an enduro helmet. I do have an enduro helmet, but it's not so suitable if I'm gonna be riding fast, especially with the peak. Modular helmets, I do have one as well. Not really a fan of it because of the heaviness, and I don't smoke. Mostly people here in Malaysia, they buy modular helmets because they want the flexibility of getting an open face. But I think it's mainly because they want to smoke some cigs without taking off their helmet while on the bike or stuff like that. Or even grab a drink of water on their adventure bike. They can have the water flask, so they can just flip the helmet open, grab a drink, without having to take off the entire full face. Now, talking about full faces, there are a few levels of full fans. Usually they will divide them into entry level, the mid-range level, and of course the top-end level, which are usually the race, their premier helmets. Of course, if you want to talk about which is the best helmet, of course, in any motorcycle brand, helmet brand, their top-of-the-end helmets will be the best helmets to get. But usually they are quite expensive, although some are quite decent. For myself, any helmet that is below the 2,000 ringgit range for a premier line helmet, I believe is pretty reasonable in my book. If you are going up more than 2,000 or 3,000, 4,000, then I bet you that will be in the lines of the AGV Pista, the full carbon fiber, those type of helmets. So those I think is actually pretty expensive. I haven't really gotten one at that much of a cost. So if you can't get those top of the line premier helmets, then going for the mid-range or entry level is okay, I would say. It's not to say they are bad helmets, of course. It's all dollars and cents. You pay less, you get less features, less aerodynamics, stuff like that. You pay top dollar, you get all the goodies. All from their racing, product testing for racing and all that. Are they really worth it? Some people might ask, is it really worth to get a premier helmet? Or is it just all hype? Or is it just because you want some Rossi graphics, you want some Marquez graphics, you wanna be a racer like them? For myself, I was actually in the same opinion as well. I was thinking before this that, helmet is a helmet, man. What bullshit, you don't need to get a premier helmet when you can just get a couple hundred bucks helmet. Well, I've been down the road, been there, done that, and I have to say that once I've gotten my hands on a premier helmet, my first premier helmet was actually, it's not even the top-end helmet, but it was a pretty costly helmet. That would be the Shoei XR1100 or RF1100 in some countries. That was actually my first premier helmet. Prior to that, I was having a few other helmets that were either entry level or intermediate level helmets. Once I got my hands on the XR1100, tried it, bought it, used it. From then on, it was all premier, baby. Premier or nothing for myself. Doesn't mean that you must get a premier helmet, but after trying on the XR1100 and understanding why you're paying that much for the brand and also the helmet model, then only I actually finally understood exactly why. God damn it, which lane do you want to be at, motherfucker? Look at this dumb shit. Anywho, as I was saying before I was so rudely interrupted, God damn it, where's your fucking signal? As I was saying, once I got myself the premier line helmet or the top end, top range helmet, I understood exactly why or exactly why it costs that much. I just couldn't go back. Would I recommend everyone to do it? It depends on your money, it depends on your budget. I can't say that, hey man, you should get a premier helmet, all the rest, and fuck all the rest. Depends on some people, they really can't afford it, they don't have it in their budget. But for those who can afford it, I'll say go for it. Because it's really worth the investment you are giving in terms of comfort. It's not for showing off. Okay, don't get me wrong, it's not about showing off. Hey guys, I got an RI, I'm a fucking boss. Nah, it's not about showing off, but some people actually show off. That's where you have a misconception. You're paying top dollar for the top brands, for the top end helmets, because they really are comfortable, they have good aerodynamics, you get good features, the venting, the ventilation. That's why you're paying top dollar for it. Some other helmets, the intermediate ones, they still have what the top end gives, but in a slightly toned down fashion. Some might be heavier than the top end helmet. Some might not have that nice of a graphics. Nah, I don't think graphics is an issue. Yeah, it's mostly the materials they use. The lining, the fit and feel, stuff like that. Even aerodynamics. I have feedback from friends that use some entry-level helmets, and they tell you that, man, this helmet really wobbles in high speeds. And once they got their hands on a premium line helmet, they'll be like, holy shit, this is so fucking comfortable, and I'm so at ease riding fast. I'm not worried anymore or frustrated. Because if your helmet is not fitting you well, it's head shaking a lot, you can't really focus on riding because the helmet is just shaking your head all over the place like a fucker, like a motherfucking milkshake. Wow, tak ada plate abang. Power lalu. Ke plate jatuh ni. Yeah, so I think that's just about the basics I want to cover about helmets, and mostly about full face. Whichever helmet you're using, the most important thing is the fitting is correct. Don't just buy a helmet just because it looks cool, but you don't actually feel comfortable wearing it. No denying that every helmet has its own internal head shape, and every one of us has a slightly different head shape. Some have some alien head, weirdo. So make sure you get the right helmet that fits you correctly, so that you have a fun time riding. Focus on the ride, enjoy the twisties, and you're not concerned about whether I'm going to get a dizzy or I'm going to have a migraine later, or I'm going to feel like my head is going to explode because of the pressure points. I've been there, down that road as well. The size was correct, head shape, interior head shape not correct, and that's where I had a lot of pressure wearing the helmet. So it's all based on true story, bro. Okay, I'm not soaked up too bad, not shivering that much, so I guess I end this on a high note without any wet underwear yet, but I can feel it starting to creep up my crotch, the water. Anywho's, Cyborg here. Ride safe, safe ride. And if you're interested in motovlogging, check out the motovlog community, motovlog.com. Thanks again for the likes, your subscriptions, and your views. Alright, I'm out of here.